Okay, so there's a few different ways that we can do this last bit, but since it's kind of getting late, I'm going to play it safe. And I think the first thing I'm going to do is there was something about that zonal geometry as table that was kind of nice and simple. And so if I can ask to pull it up, let's get the area of the parking zones. They should all be the same, but and we should actually be able to figure this out without running this tool, but again, it's getting late, so I'm just going to say this is, I'm going to call it 05, area of the kind of parking zones. And what do you think this number is going to be? They should all be the same, correct? So do you remember how to go look at this thing at the bottom here? Area 22,500 for every single one. Does that make sense? Why does that make sense? Because of the pixel size and the number of them and the number of pixels in each zone. Okay, so 22,500 is what we have to remember here. So now what we could do is pretty simple. We're interested in this the parking in each zone, and let's take up the raster calculator and bring it up. And so let's take this guy and then basically just say, hey, let's divide every the value in every location by this constant of 22,500, right? And this should be our final answer. And it's going to be called the percent of parking, percent area for parking in each zone. Kind of, right? With one caveat. You know what that caveat's going to be? And so if I say okay. Okay, so let's start like trying to make sense of that at what we just did. And I'm going to look at. Okay, so I'm interested in my parking zones, but I don't want to look at them in this like crazy color anymore. I want to make it a little bit simpler. So I'm going to go to stretched, and I'm going to show them on this grayscale. Okay, so did you see how I did that? I went, double-clicked on this, went to symbology, went to stretched, and then went over here, and then I want this to be a grayscale. And I say apply. And now I have this kind of background, and I might even invert it, because it for some reason it makes me nervous that that's all heavy there. I like the heavy stuff to sit on the bottom, otherwise I feel like you know, gravity's being violated. Right, so doesn't this make sense? Like everything settles to the bottom. Okay, so maybe I just like French presses, but that's my background, and I'm just using gray. And then on top of that, I've got this guy. And first of all, what would you expect? So let's just look at this parking in each zone, and let's do something where we stop looking at this guy. So zero, I want to stop looking at. So I'm going to double click on that patch here in symbology and say no color and say okay. And so now I'm not even looking at that background at value anymore. And what I'd like to say is that, okay, this is one cell out of 25. So what is its percent value going to be? 4%. Does that make sense? So something that has 2 should be about 8%. Does that make sense? So what's the greatest number that you could possibly expect a parking zone to have? It would be 100, right? So what if we wound up kind of taking this and saying, look, I want to classify this into three numbers. And I really want to know what is below 9%, because that's what Alexander said is healthy. And then I'll take one as like the high. And then anything that's between 1 and 11 is nonsense. It's this kind of area that's not parking, that's kind of mucking up our results, right? And so if I say apply, we should now get three values. And if I go in here and say, actually, I want this to be no color because I don't care to see it. I want this, anything that's less than 9%, to be something kind of good, like cretin blue, I'm going to go with for now. And here I'm going to go with this kind of fire red, because these are places that are violating this pattern and saying apply. And so do you see what I'm getting? Does that make sense that these are kind of now showing the zones basically that have parking that meets the pattern, and these are kind of showing the zones that have parking that do not meet the pattern. And all we really want to do is see this as a table, which we can't do. So it's heartbreaking that we can't see a table here, but here's why. If we go into properties and then go over to source, the pixel type, meaning the data type of the values for each pixel, is these are floating points. And what that means is that it's storing basically decimal numbers and quite a few of them. If you look at that, it's quite impressive. So if we click on this, right, the value is 0.04 with a bunch of zeros afterwards. If we click on this, the value is not just 11, but it's 11 with a bunch of zeros after it. Whereas if we went and looked at, this guy, it's just an integer. And so everything in the parking zones, if you click on it, parking zones are just going to be regular old numbers with no decimal places, right? Basically, Arc, I think, is going to protest to create an attribute to be able to create an attribute table whenever you have a raster that is a floating point, and that'll make more sense, I think, as we go along. So for now, what we could do is if we go open up this guy, this basically reported for each of our zones that has parking in it. It gave us the area. So we could add a field here if we go over to this kind of funny little. I don't know what that really is supposed to be, and then went to add field, and we could call this thing the percent, and it's probably going to be a little stingy on how long you can kind of make that, but I'm just going to say percent, and you definitely don't want spaces, and then we don't want to store this as an integer, we want to store this as float, because we'd like to store decimal places, and if we say okay, now we can go and right click on the thing that says percent, go to field calculator, and it's going to say this, and it's a nice little warning, but we're just going to live dangerously. And what we'll do is we'll take double click on area. So what you're telling it basically is take the value from this column, for each row, take the column from this value, and then take the value from this column, and then divide it by, and let's give it this constant of 22,500, right, which is the area of each parking zone. And if we say okay, then lo and behold, we have a table here that for any zone that has parking, it tells you the percentage, right? So the values here, I believe, are the zone IDs, right? And so there's, and then the percentage are the percent of the parking in each zone. So we weren't able to create a table because, so the do you, importantly, do you see the kind of what's missing from our table? Or basically any zones that don't have parking in them. But this is a good start, right? So this is kind of a reasonable answer at this point, is to have your percentages and then to also have a map that looks something like this. And when you get to this point, call an instructor over and talk to him a little bit, and then good job. Oh, but wait a minute. One thing that's different about ArcMap and ArcCatalog is ArcMap is a document that you can save. And I'm sorry, I haven't saved it yet. Probably should have shown you how to do that a little bit earlier. Let's just move into where we were working. And under lab one, I'm going to save this as the lab one, and then hit return. And it's going to save it as an MXD file. So if we go look at this guy, you'll see under here that there is lab one ArcGIS map document. And that's good, and now you can come back to this if you ever should want to. And well done. Thanks. See you later.